And now, in this lecture, we'll answer on two questions. In the first question, we'll find out the blue area. And in the second question, we'll find out the radius of this circle that blocks triangle ABC. So, first of all, let's start with the first question. Here in the drawing, we have the big circle. The radius of the big circle is equal to 13 units, and AB is the diameter of the big circle, and the triangle ABC is inscribed by the big circle, and the small circle is inscribed by triangle ABC, and the radius of the big circle is equal to 4 units, and we want to find out the blue area. Okay, so first of all, we define the center of the small circle as O. We define the point of tendency of tangent CB in the small circle SM. We define the point of tendency of tangent AC with the small circle SN. We define the point of tendency of tangent AB with the small circle SL. And then we join points O and M together by a straight line. Line segment OM starts from point O, that is the center of the small circle, and ends at point M, that is the point on the small circle itself. This is exactly the definition of a radius. So OM is the radius of the small circle, so we define the radius of the small circle as R, and R equals to 4 units according to what is given as the question. In the next step, here, we join points O and N together by a straight line. Point O is the center of the small circle. Point N is a point on the small circle itself. This is exactly the definition of a radius. So NO is also the radius of the small circle, that is equal to 4 units. So here we have the rule number 1 that says that a tangent to a circle is perpendicular to the radius drawn to its point of tendency. Here the radius ON of the small circle, it is drawn to the point of tendency, that is to say it is drawn to point N, that is the point of tendency of tangent AC with the small circle. And whenever you have a radius that is drawn to the point of tendency, then tangent AC will be perpendicular to the radius NO. So AC is perpendicular to NO. It means that this angle equals to 90 degrees, and this angle will be also equal to 90 degrees according to rule number 1. And here we also have the radius OM that is drawn to the point of tendency, that is to say it is drawn to point M, that is the point of tendency, of tendency B, the small circle. And whenever you have a radius that is drawn to the point of tendency, then tendency B will be perpendicular to the radius MO. Again, CB is perpendicular to MO, that is to say, this angle equals to 90 degrees, and this angle will be also equal to 90 degrees according to rule number one. In addition, we have also another rule according to the following rule. Any peripheral angle that rests on the diameter of a circle equals to 90 degrees. Here, peripheral angle ACB, this angle rests on side AB, that is the diameter of the circle, therefore it is equal to 90 degrees according to the rule that I mentioned. So actually, this angle equals to 90 degrees. So actually, in quadrilateral ONCM, we have 1, 2, 3 right angles. So I write it down. In quadrilateral ONCM, we have three right angles. The sum of three right angles is 90 times 3 is 270 degrees, plus the size of the fourth angle, that is actual angle MON. In total, the sum of those four angles must be equal to 360 degrees, according to the rule that the sum of the angles in any quadrilateral is equal to 360 degrees. So here we subtract 270 degrees from this equation, and we get that the missing angle, angle MON, equals to 360 degrees minus 270 degrees, it is 90 degrees. So I found out that the missing angle, angle MON, equals to 90 degrees, it is the right angle. So I can write here that this angle, angle MON, equals to 90 degrees. So actually I found out that all the angles inside quadrilateral MONC are right angles. And any quadrilateral that has four right angles must be at least a rectangle, if not a square. So we relate to quadrilateral ONCM as a rectangle. Okay, quadrilateral ONCM is a rectangle. But we also know that the opposite sides of a rectangle are equal to each other. That is to say, NO equals to CM. NO equals to CM. I repeat again, according to the rule that the opposite sides of a rectangle are equal to each other. So a rectangle NOCM, NO equals to CM. Okay, but we have only found out that NO equals to 4 units. Here, NO equals to 4 units. And from this equation, 4 equals to NO equals to CM. we conclude that CM is also equals to 4 units. Okay? LCM is also equals to 4 units. Likewise, according to the rule that the opposite sides of a rectangle are equal to each other, so rectangle NOCM, OM equals to NC. OM equals to NC. OM equals to NC. But we have already found out that OM equals to 4 units. It is the radius of the circle. So I can argue that OM equals to 4 units. And from this equation, 4 equals to OM equals to NC, we derive that NC is also equals to 4 units. NC is also equals to 4 units. You can write here that NC equals to 4 units. In the next step, we will define side AC of triangle ABC as A. So here, side AC equals to A, according to our definition. We'll write it down that side AC equals to A, according to our definition. We define side BC as B. Here, side BC equals to B according to our definition. So write it here that BC of CB, CB equals to B according to our definition. And we define the diameter AB, that is also side AB of triangle ABC, is C. AB equals to C according to our definition. Okay, side AB, that is the diameter of the big circle, equals to C according to our definition. So, what is the length of side AN, or line segment AN? It's very easy to see from the drawing that AN equals to AC minus NC. Again, AC minus NC equals to AN. So actually AN equals to AC, and AC equals to A according to our definition, minus NC. NC equals to 4 units according to what we already found out. So in conclusion, we found out that AN equals to A minus 4. AN equals to A minus 4. You can write here that AN equals to A minus 4. Likewise, we find out the length of line segment MB. For the moment, it will be easy to see that the length of line segment MB is equal to CB minus CM. Again, CB minus CM equals to MB. So actually MB equals to CB, but CB equals to B according to our definition, minus CM. We have already found out that CM equals to 4 units. So actually in conclusion, we found out that MB equals to B minus 4. So I'm writing down that MB equals to B minus 4. Okay. In the next step, I present to you rule number 2. According to rule number 2, the lengths of two tangents from a common external point to a circle are equal. I repeat again. According to rule number 2, the lengths of two tangents from a common external point to a circle are equal. So if we focus on the common external point, point A, actually, from the common external point, point A, we have two tangents to the small circle. The first tangent is tangent AL, and the second tangent is tangent AN. And according to rule number 2, they are equal to each other. So actually, AL equals to AN according to rule number 2. But we have already found out that AN equals to A minus 4. So we can write here that AN equals to A minus 4. And from this equation, AN equals to AN equals to A minus 4, we derive that AL is also equals to A minus 4. AN equals to A minus 4. So we can write here that AL equals to A minus 4. In the next step, we focus on the common external point, point B. From the common external point, point B, we have two tangents to the small circle. The first tangent is tangent BL, and the second tangent is tangent BM. And according to rule number 2, the lengths of those two tangents are equal to each other. That is to say, BL equals to BM according to rule number 2. But we have already found out that BM equals to B minus 4. So I can write here that BM equals to B minus 4. And from this equation, BM equals to BM equals to B minus 4, we derive that BN is also equals to B minus 4. BN equals to B minus 4, so I can write here on the drawing that BL or LB equals to B minus 4. According to our definition, AB equals to C. AB is the diameter of the circle, and diameter is twice as long as the radius. So if we define the radius of the big circle as capital R, then the diameter will be equal to 2R. So C, that is equal to AB, will be equal to 2R, 2 times capital R, but R equals to 13 units according to what is given as the question. So C equals to 2R, and R equals to 13 units, therefore 2 times 13 is 26 units. So I found out that the diameter of the circle, the big circle, equals to 26 units. Okay. So actually, the diameter AB that is equal to C equals to 26 units from one side, but from the other side, we actually found out that the diameter from the drawings is very easy to see. The diameter AB of the circle equals to AL plus LB. Is equal to AL plus LB. I repeat again, the diameter of the big circle that is equal to AB and also C according to our definition is equal to 26 units from one side, but from the other side, from the domain, it is very easy to see that the diameter of the circle AB equals to AL plus LB. So according to equation number one, we get that 26 equals to AL plus LB. Okay. So 26 equals to 26, that is the diameter of the big circle, equals to AL. But AL equals to A minus 4. So we substitute AL by A minus 4 plus LB. LB, we already found out that LB equals to B minus 4, so we substitute LB by B minus 4. So actually, in the conclusion, we found out that according to equation number 1, A plus B minus 4 plus minus 4 is minus 8. So it is A plus B minus 8 equals to 26. That is the length of the diameter of the big circle. So here we'll add 8 to this equation, equation number one, and we'll get it according to equation number one. A plus B equals to 8 minus 30 is 0, and 26 plus 8 is 34. So we found out that A plus B equals to 34 according to equation number 1. Here we square this equation, equation number 1. And we get that according to equation number 1, A plus B squared equals to 34 squared. Here we'll open the brackets on both sides of this equation, equation number 1, and we get that according to equation number 1, A plus B squared equals to A squared plus B squared plus 2 times AB. And this is equal to 34 squared. 34 squared is 1156. Okay, so actually found out that according to equation number 1, A squared plus B squared plus 2 times AB equals to 1156. Okay. So in the next step, we'll focus on the right triangle ABC. Triangle ABC is the right triangle because angle ACB equals to 90 degrees. And we'll implement the Pythagoras theorem on the right triangle ABC. So in triangle ABC, by PT is the relation for Pythagoras theorem. According to the Pythagoras theorem, the square of the hypotenuse equals to the sum of the squares of the perpendiculars. So actually, the hypotenuse in the right triangle ABC is AB. This is in front of the angle that is equal to 90 degrees. Therefore, AB is the hypotenuse. And the square of the hypotenuse is AB squared. And it is equal to the sum of the squares of the perpendiculars. It is equal to AC squared plus CB squared. So, we found out that according to equation number 2, AB squared equals to AC squared plus CB squared. AB equals to C, according to our definition, so AB squared is C squared. And C squared equals to AC squared, AC equals to A, according to our definition, so AC squared is A squared plus CB squared. CB equals to B, according to our definition, so CB squared is B squared. So in conclusion, we found out that C squared equals to A squared plus B squared, according to equation number 2. But we already found out that C equals to 26 units. This is the diameter of the big circle. Therefore, C squared is 26 squared. So according to question number 2, 26 squared equals to a square plus b square. So 26, so according to the equation of Rodolfo, we found out that a square plus b square equals to 26 square, and 26 square is 676. So actually, according to equation number 1, we found out that a square plus b square equals to, if only the equation number 2, actually, according to equation number 2, we found out that a square plus b square equals to 676. And because of the fact that a square plus b square equals to 676, according to equation number 2, we can substitute a square plus b square in equation number 1 here by 676. If we do it now, we get that according to equation number 1, a square plus b square is 676 according to equation number 2. So we substitute a square plus b square by 676 plus 2ab, that is equal to 1156 according to equation number 1. Here we subtract 676 from this equation number 1. And we'll get that according to equation number 1, two times AB equals to 1156 minus 676 is 480. So here we divide this equation number 1 by 2, and we get that according to equation number 1, A times B equals to 480 over 2 is 240. And then we divide this equation number 1 by 2, and we get that according to equation number 1, A times B over 2 equals to 120. A times B over 2 equals to 120 according to equation number 1. But what is actually the blue area? The blue area from drawing is very easy to see, that the blue area equals to the area of triangle ABC, the big triangle ABC, minus the area of the small circle. Okay, so the area of the blue shape from the drawing, it is very easy to see that the area of the blue shape is equal to the area of the big triangle ABC minus the area of the small circle. Very simple. You see it easier from the drawing. I repeat again, the area of the blue shape from the drawing is very easy to see, it is equal to the area of triangle ABC minus the area of the small circle. Okay, so the area of the blue shape So the area of the blue shape equals to the area of triangle ABC. What is the area of triangle ABC? The area of triangle ABC equals to the base of the triangle, that is AC. Times the I to the base. The I to the base is CB over 2. I repeat again, the area of triangle ABC equals to the base of the triangle, that is AC, times the I to the base, that is CB over 2. Here you can see that the I to the base is CB because of the fact that CB creates 90 degrees with the base AC. For that reason, CB is the I to the base, because the I always must create 90 degrees with the base. So, the area of triangle ABC is AC times CB over 2 minus the area of the small circle. We know that the radius of the small circle equals to 4 units. And the area of the small circle equals to pi r squared, and r equals to 4 units. Okay? The area of the small circle is pi r squared, and r equals to 4 units. So the area of the blue shape, it is equal to AC. AC equals to A according to our definition, times CB. CB equals to B according to our definition, over 2. So the area of triangle ABC equals to A times B over 2, minus the area of the small circle, that is pi r squared. But r equals to 4 units, so r squared is 4 squared, that is 16. So the area of the small circle equals to 16 pi. So in conclusion, we found out that the area of the blue shape is equal to the area of triangle ABC, that is A times B over 2. A times B over 2 equals to 120. You can see it here. According to equation number 1, A times B over 2 equals to 120. So we substitute A times B over 2 by 120. Minus 16 pi. So we actually found out that the area of the blue shape equals to 120 minus 16 pi square units, or in terms of numbers, it is equal to 69.73 square units. I'll repeat again, we actually found out that the area of the blue shape in the denominator is equal to either 120 minus 16 pi square units, so in terms of numbers, it is equal to 69.73 square units. Okay, so we finished with the first question. In the next step, I'll present to you the second question, and we will solve the second question in 3 different methods. Okay? So, here in the drawing, we have this circle. And inside this circle, we have triangle ABC. Triangle ABC is inscribed by this circle. And we know that the area of this triangle ABC equals to 9 square units. We also know that side AB of triangle ABC equals to 5 units, side BC equals to 6 units, and we want to find out the area of this circle that blocks triangle ABC. Okay, we start with the first method. So here, from point A, we'll draw perpendicular on BC. So actually, this angle equals to 90 degrees, and this angle also equals to 90 degrees according to our construction. We define the touching point of the perpendicular from point A and BC as D. And we actually know that the area of this triangle ABC equals to 9 square units. So we can write here that the area of triangle ABC is equal to 9 square units. This will be equation number 1. But the area of any triangle, it is equal to the base of the triangle. In this case, is the base of triangle ABC is BC, times the height to the base. The height must be 90 degrees with the base, so AD is the height to the base, times AD over 2. I repeat again that the area of triangle ABC is BC times AD over 2. It is giving us the question that BC equals to 6 units, you can see here. So we substitute BC by 6. So the area of triangle ABC equals to 6 times AD over 2. So according to equation number 1, we actually found out that equals to 6 over 2 is 3. So it is 3 times AD. So here we divide this equation number 1 by 3, and we get that according to equation number 1, the missing 9 segment AD equals to 9 over 3, that is 3 units. AD equals to 3 units. So we can write here that AD equals to 3 units. In the next step, we'll focus on the right triangle ABD. On the right triangle ABD, according to the Pythagoras theorem, here by PT is a relation for Pythagoras theorem. The square of the hypotenuse equals to the sum of the squares of the perpendiculars. So in the right triangle ABD, the hypotenuse is AB, therefore the square of the hypotenuse is AB squared. And it must be equal to the sum of the squares of the perpendiculars, that is to say it must be equal to AD squared. Plus BD squared. So in the right triangle ABD, according to the Pythagoras theorem, we found out that AD squared equals to AD squared plus BD squared. Okay, so AB is 5, so AB squared is 5 squared, that is 25. And it is equal to AD squared. AD is 3, so AD squared is 3 squared, that is 9, plus BD squared. some conclusion, we found out that 25 equals to 9 plus bd squared. Here we subtract 9 from this equation, equation number 2, and we get that the quantity of equation number 2, 25 minus 9 is 16. So 16 equals to bd squared. Here we take root out of this equation, equation number 2, and we get that according to equation number 2, bd equals to the square root of 16, that is 4. So bd equals to 4 units. So actually, can write down here that BD equals to 4 units. Okay? And what is the length of line segment DC? From the moment, it's very easy to see that DC is equal to BC minus here. DC equals to BC minus BD. BC minus BD. So DC equals to BC equals to 6 units according to what is given as the question. And we just like now found out that BD equals to 4. So in conclusion, we found out that DC equals to 6 minus 4, that is 2. So DC equals to 2 units. DC equals to 2 units. We write here that in the drawing that DC equals to 2 units. In the next step, we'll focus on the right triangle ADC, and we'll implement the Pythagoras theorem on the right triangle ADC. So in the right triangle ADC, by PT is the version for Pythagoras theorem, the square of the hypotenuse equals to the sum of the squares of the perpendiculars. The hypotenuse is AC. Therefore, the square of the hypotenuse is AC squared. And it is equal to the sum of the squares of the perpendiculars. That is to say, it is equal to AD squared plus DC squared. And again, in the right triangle ADC, according to the Pythagoras theorem, we get that AC squared equals to AD squared plus DC squared. So if AC squared equals to AD squared. AD equals to 3, so AD squared is 3 squared, that is 9, plus DC squared. DC equals to 2, so DC squared is 2 squared, that is 4. So in conclusion, we found out that AC squared equals to 9 plus 4, that is 13. Here we take a root out of this equation number 3, and we get that AC equals to the square root of 13 units. AC equals to the square root of 13 units. So I can write here that AC equals to the square root of 13 units. In the next step, we'll define the center of this circle as O. So here, this is the center of the circle. And from point A, we'll join points A and O together by a straight line. And then we'll extend line segment AO by a straight line until it touches the circle. And we define the touching point of the extended line segment AO and the circle as E. So here, chord AE or line segment AE passes through the center of this circle from point O. Therefore, chord AE is defined as the diameter of this circle. AE is the diameter of the circle. So if we define the radius of the big circle as R, then we know that the diameter of the circle is twice as long as the radius, so the diameter AE will be equal to 2 times capital R. Okay? In the next step, we will join points B and E together by a straight line. So actually, we created the peripheral angle ABE. Angle ABE is defined as peripheral angle, and peripheral angle ABE rests on AE, that is the diameter of this circle. And we have the rule that any peripheral angle that rests on the diameter of a circle equals to 90 degrees. And because of the fact that peripheral angle ABE rests on AE, that is the diameter of this circle, it must be equal to 90 degrees according to the rule that I mentioned. So if angle ABE equals to 90 degrees, because angle ABE rests on the diameter, therefore it is equal to 90 degrees. Okay, so can I tell that angle ABE equals to 90 degrees according to the rule that I mentioned. We also have another rule. Here, if we focus on side AB, on chord AB, we have 2 peripheral angles that rest on chord AB. Those 2 peripheral angles, they are both rests on chord AB, therefore they are equal to each other according to the following rule. It says that peripheral angles that rest on the same chord are equal to each other, okay? Again, peripheral angles that rest on the same chord are equal to each other. So those 2 peripheral angles, they both rest on the same chord, chord AB, therefore they are equal to each other. So I'm writing down angle AEB, this angle equals to this angle, that is actually angle ACB. repeat again, according to the rule that peripheral angles that rest on the same chord are equal to each other, we get that angle AEB equals to angle ACB. So if we define angle ACB as theta, this angle equals to theta according to our definition, then from this equation, angle AEB equals to angle ACB equals to theta, we will derive that angle AEB is also equals to theta. Okay. Here, angle AEB is also equals to theta. So, if we focus on the right triangle, triangle AEB, angle ABE equals to 90 degrees. Angle ABE equals to 90 degrees, angle AEB equals to theta. Therefore, this angle, angle BAE, must be equal to 90 degrees minus theta in order to complete the sum of the angles in triangle ABE, 280 degrees. This angle must be equal to 90 degrees minus theta. And here we'll get that 90 degrees minus theta plus theta equals to 90 degrees, and 90 degrees plus 90 degrees, it is equal to 180 degrees. And exactly for the same reason, this angle, angle DAC, also must be equal to 90 degrees minus theta. Here this angle equals to theta, this angle equals to 90 degrees, therefore this angle must be equal to 90 degrees minus theta in order to complete the sum of the angles, 280 degrees, this angle must be equal to 90 degrees minus theta. So in the next step, we'll prove that the right green triangle AEB is similar to the right green triangle ADC. So we prove that those two green right triangles are similar to each other. So I write it down here. We prove the triangle AEB, this triangle, is similar to this triangle, this right green triangle ADC. So why those two triangles are similar to each other? First of all, we have those two angles that are both equal to 90 degrees, therefore they are equal to each other. So we can write down here that angle ABE equals to this angle, that is angle ADC, and they are both equal to 90 degrees. Therefore they are equal to each other, so here angle AB equals to angle ADC equals to 90 degrees. In addition, we have those two angles that are both equal to theta, therefore they are equal to each other. So angle AEB equals to this angle, that is actually angle ACB, ACD, and they are both equal to theta, therefore they are equal to each other. I repeat again, angle AEB equals to angle ACD equals to theta. And finally, those two angles are both equal to 90 degrees minus theta, therefore they are equal to each other. So here angle BAE equals to this angle, that is actual angle DAC. And they are both equal to 90 degrees minus theta, therefore they are equal to each other. I repeat again, angle BA equals to angle DAC equals to 90 degrees minus theta. So we actually found out that all the angles of triangle ABE can go into all the angles of triangle DAC. Therefore, those two triangles are similar to each other according to angle similarity rule. I write it down. Triangle ABE is similar. This is the sign of similar to triangle ADC. According to angle similarity rule. And from the fact that the two green triangles are similar to each other, we will conclude, hence, that the following equation is true, that AB over AD, AB over AD, equals to AE over AC. I repeat again, from the fact that the two green triangles are similar to each other, we conclude that AB over AD equals to AE over AC. So here AB equals to 5 units, AD equals to 3 units, AE is the diameter of this circle that is equal to 2R, 2 times capital R, over AC, AC equals to the square root of 13 units. So in conclusion, I found out that according to equation number 3, 5 over 3 equals to 2R over square root of 13. Here we multiply this equation by square root of 13, and we get that according to equation number 3, 5 times square root of 13 over 3 equals to 2R. Here we divide this equation number 3, by 2, and we get that according to equation number 3, R, the radius of the circle that we are looking for, equals to 5 times square root of 13 over 6 units. Again, R equals to 5 times square root of 13, 5 times square root of 13 over 6 units. In terms of numbers, it is equal to 3.00, that is a little bit greater than 3 units. Okay, repeat again, the radius of this circle that looks like ABC equals to either 5 times square root of 13 over 6 units, or in terms of numbers, it is a little bit greater than 3 units. So finished with the first method. In the next step, I'll present to you how to find out the radius of this circle that blocks triangle ABC according to the second method. Okay. the second method we use for the things that we have already found out in the first method. Here from point A we draw perpendicular on BC. So this area equals to 90 degrees. And this area also equals to 90 degrees according to our construction. We define the touching point of the perpendicular from point A and BC as D. We have already found out that AD equals to 3 units in the first method, DC equals to 2 units, and BD equals to 4 units, so I'm not repeating it. In the next step, we will extend the perpendicular AD by a straight line until it touches the circle, and we define the touching point of the extended AD in the circle is E. Actually, according to the rule that the sum of the angles on one side of a straight line is equal to 180 degrees, this angle also must be equal to 90 degrees, and this angle also must be equal to 90 degrees. So actually all the angles around point D are right angles that are equal to 90 degrees. So here I present to you rule number one that I have already mentioned in the past, so we'll do it quickly. So this is rule number one. If chord AB intersects with chord CD with point O, then the following equation is true, that AO times OB equals to CO times OD. So here we have chord AB. This is chord AB that intersects with chord CD. This is called CD, and the intersection point between chord AB and chord CD is at this point, point O. So here, if this is the data that has been given to us, then according to rule number one, we get that AO times OB equals to CO times OD. I repeat again. If chord AB intersects with chord CD at point O, then AO times OB equals to CO times OD. Again, AO times OB equals to CO times OD. We actually can implement rule number one in our drawing. Why? Because in our drawing we have this circle. Inside this circle we have chord AE that intersects with chord BC at point D. Point D is the intersection point of chord AE with chord BC. Therefore, according to rule number one, we get that BD times DC equals to AD times DE. Okay. Again, called AE intercept before the BC at point D, therefore, going to rule number one, BD times DC equals to AE times DE. So, BD equals to 4 units, DC equals to 2 units, and it is equal to AD, AD equals to 3 units, times DE is the missing 9 seconds, so we leave it as it is. So in conclusion, we found out that 4 times 2 equals to 3 times DE, so 4 times 2 is 8, and 8 equals to 3 times DE. Here we divide this equation by 3, and we get the DE, the missing line segment, equals to 8 over 3 units. So here DE equals to 8 over 3 units. You can write here in the drawing, the DE equals to 8 over 3 units. In the next step, I will present to you rule number 2, and we implement rule number 2 in our drawing. So here we have this circle, and inside this circle we have called AB. That intersects with called CD. This is called CD at 90 degrees. So they create 90 degrees at the intersection point between them. So those two angles are all equal to 90 degrees because at the intersection point they create 90 degrees with each other. So if the intersection point is point O, the length of CO is A, the length of OD is B units, the length of AO is C units, and the length of OB is D units. This is rule number 2. Then the following equation is true, that 4 times R squared equals to A squared plus B squared plus C squared plus D squared. So repeat on rule number 2, if chord AB intersects with chord CD at 90 degrees, so chord AB creates 90 degrees with chord CD at the intersection point. All these angles are right angles, so all the angles around point O are right angles, then and this is the data that has been given to us, then the following equation is true, that 4 times R squared, R is the radius of this circle that contains the two chords, 4 times R squared equals to A squared plus B squared plus C squared plus D squared. Okay, so we actually can implement rule number 2 in our drawing, because in our drawing we have chord AE that intersects with chord BC at 90 degrees. Around point D, all the angles are right angles, they are equal to 90 degrees. Therefore, according to rule number 2, we get that 4 times R square. R is the radius of this circle that contains the two chords. And this that is the radius that you are looking for. In this question, 4 times R square equals to BD square. Plus DC square plus AD square plus DE square. Again, chord AE intersects with chord DC at 90 degrees, therefore 4 times R square equals to BD square plus DC square plus AD square plus DE square. And 4 times R square equals to BD square plus DC square plus AD square plus DE square. According to rule number 2, of course, this rule, so 4 times R square equals to BD square. BD equals to 4, so BD square is 4 squared, that is 16. Plus this, plus DC square, DC is 2, so DC square is 2 squared, that is 4. Plus AD square, AD equals to 3 units, so AD square is 3 squared, that is 9. Plus DE square. DE equals to 8 over 3, so DE square is 8 over 3 square, that is 64 over 9. So in conclusion, we found out that 4E square equals to 16 plus 4 plus 9 plus 64 over 9. 16 plus 4 is 20, and 20 plus 9 is 29, so we have 29 plus 64 over 9. 4 R square equals to 29 plus 64 over 9. Here we'll multiply 29 by 9 and then we divide it by 9 in order to have a common factor of this expression. 29 times 9 is 261 plus 64 over 9. Here 261 plus 64 is 325 over 9. So in conclusion, we found out that 4 times R square equals to 325 over 9. Here we divide this equation by 4 and we get that R square equals to 325 over 9 times 4 is 36. 325 equals to 25 times 13, so we substitute that 325 by 25 times 13 over 36. Here we take the root out of this equation and we get that R, the radius that we are looking for, is equal to the square root of 25 is 5, the square root of 36 is 6, times square root of 13. So we found out that R, the radius that we are looking for, equals to either 5 times square root of 13 over 6 units, or in terms of numbers, it is a little bit greater than 3 units. Okay? Here, R, the radius of this circle that blocks triangle ABC, equals to either 5 over 6 times square root of 13 units, or in terms of numbers, it is a little bit greater than 3 units. We finished with the second method. In the next step, I will present to you how to find out the radius of this circle that blocks triangle ABC according to the third method. Okay? In the first method, we will define angle ABC as theta. And you actually have a special formula to find out the area of any triangle. If we have a triangle ABC, that could be any triangle. This is triangle ABC. We know that the angle between side AB and side AC is theta. We also know that the length of side AB is equal to A units in its length. Side AC equals to B units in its length. Then the area of this triangle ABC will be equal to A times B times sinus theta over 2. Okay, the area of this triangle BC equals to A times B times sinus theta over 2. We use this formula in order to calculate the area of triangle ABC. So here we have this triangle ABC. According to the new formula, the area on this triangle ABC will be equal to 5 times 6 times sinus theta over 2. The area of our triangle ABC equals to 5 times 6 times sinus theta over 2 according to the new formula. But it is given us the question that the area of triangle ABC equals to 9 square units. Okay? So according to question number 1, we found out that 9 equals to 5 times 6 is 30 and 50 over 2 is 15. So in conclusion, we found out that 9 equals to 15 times sinus theta. Here we divide this equation number 1. By 3, and we get that according to equation number 1, 15 over 3 is 5, so here this side of the equation we have 5 times sinus theta, that is equal to 9 over 3 is 3. Here we divide this equation number 1 by 5, and we get that sinus theta, according to equation number 1, sinus theta equals to 3 fifths. Okay? Sinus theta equals to 3 fifths. We actually have the trigonometric identity that states that cosine theta equals to the square root of 1 minus sinus square theta. So actually, cosine theta equals to the square root of 1. If sinus theta equals to 3 fifths, it means that sinus square theta will be equal to 3 fifths squared, that is actually 3 squared, that is 9, over 5 squared, that is 25. So here we'll multiply 1 by 25, and then we divide it by 25 in order to overcome the factor with this expression, and we get that according to this equation, cosine theta it was the square root of 25 minus 9 over 25. 25 minus 9 is equals to 16. That is 16 over 25. The square root of 16 is 4, the square root of 25 is 5. So in conclusion, we found out that cosine theta equals to 4 fifths. Cosine theta equals to 4 fifths. In the next step, I'll present to you the law of cosines, and we will implement the law of cosines in our triangle ABC. So I already mentioned it in the past, so we'll do it quickly. So what is the law of cosines? The law of cosines is drawing a triangle. So if we have a triangle ABC, this would be any triangle. This is triangle ABC. The angle between side AB and side DC is theta. The length of side AB equals to A units. Side AC equals to B units in its length, and side BC equals to C units in its length. Then we get that according to the law of cosines, here cosine theta equals to A squared plus B squared minus C squared over 2 times A times B. So in any triangle, cosine theta equals to A squared plus B squared minus C squared over 2 times AB. We'll implement the law of cosines in our triangle ABC. According to the law of cosines, if we implement it in our triangle ABC, we get that cosine theta equals to AB squared, that is 5 squared, that is 25, plus BC squared. BC is 6, so BC squared is 6 squared, that is 36, minus AC squared. Okay, minus AC squared. Over 2 times AB, that is 5, times BC, that is 6. So actually, in conclusion, we found out that according to equation number 2, cosine theta equals to 25 plus 36 minus AC squared over 2 times 5 times 6. We have always found out that cosine theta equals to 4 fifths. So we substitute cosine theta in the equation number 2 by 4 fifths. And we get that 4 fifths equals to 25 plus 36 is 61 minus AC squared over 2 times 5 times 6 is 30, and 30 times 2 is 60. Here we multiply this equation number 2 by 60, and we will get that according to equation number 2, four over five times 60 equals to 61 minus AC squared If 60 over 5 is 12, so 12 times 4 equals to 61 minus AC squared. 12 times 4 is 48, so 48 equals to 61 minus AC squared. Here we subtract from this equation number 2, 48, and also add to equation number 2, AC squared simultaneously. And we get here that AC squared equals to 61 minus 48 is 13. Here we take a root out of this equation number 2, and we get that according to equation number 2, AC equals to the square root of 13 units. AC equals to the square root of 14 units. So here we can write down in the drawing that AC equals to the square root of 14 units. In the next step, I will present to you a new formula to calculate the area of any circle that blocks triangle. Here we have our circle blocks triangle ABC, therefore we can implement the formula that I will present to you in our drawing. Okay, so if we have a circle that blocks triangle, then the radius of the circle that is to say capital R will be equal to the multiplication of the sides of the triangle that is blocked, that is inscribed by the circle. In this case, the multiplication of the sides of triangle ABC is AB times AC times BC over 4 times the area of the triangle that is inscribed by the circle. That is to say, 4 times the area of triangle ABC in our case. Okay, so I know it is 4 times the area of triangle ABC. But because of the fact that triangle ABC could be any triangle, it is indeed a general formula that is true for any triangle that is blocked by a circle. Or triangle that is inscribed by a circle. So, the radius of this circle that blocks triangle ABC will be equal to AB is 5. AC is equal to 13. And BC is 6 over 4 times the area of triangle ABC is being given to us, and it is equal to 9 square units. So it is 4 times 9. So the radius of the circle that blocks triangle ABC will be equal to 5 times 6 is 30, so it is 30 times square root of 13 over 4 times 9 is 36. Here we will divide both the numerator and the denominator of this on this side of the equation by 6, and we get that the radius that we are looking for of the circle that blocks triangle ABC will be equal to 30 over 6 is 5 times square root of 13 over 36 over 6 is 6. So the area of this circle that blocks triangle ABC equals to either 5 over 6 times square root of 13 units, or in terms of numbers, it is a little bit greater than 3 units. We finish with the third method. In the next step, we'll summarize the lecture. We'll start with the first question, of course. So in the moving, if the big circle, that blocks triangle ABC, or triangle ABC is inscribed by the big circle, and inside triangle ABC we have the small circle, so the small circle is inscribed by triangle ABC. The radius of the big circle equals to 13 units, the radius of the small circle equals to 9 units, and we also know that AB is the diameter of the big circle, and we want to find out the blue area, okay, on the size of the blue shape, or the area of the blue shape. Okay, so first of all, we define the center of the small circle as O. We define the point of tendency of tendency B with this small circle as M. We define the point of tendency of tendency AC with this small circle as M. And we define the point of tendency of tangent AB with this small circle as L. Then we join points O and N together by a straight line. O is the center of the small circle. N is the point on the small circle itself. So this is the definition of a radius. O N is the radius of the small circle that is equal to 4 units according to what is given as the question. So here we have the radius of the small circle that is drawn to the point of tendency. And whenever we have a radius that is drawn to the point of tendency, then this angle equals to 90 degrees, and this angle equals to 90 degrees, or tangent AC is perpendicular to the radius NO, that is to say this angle equals to 90 degrees, and this angle equals to 90 degrees. For the same reason, exactly, OM is also the radius of the small circle, that is equal to 4 units, and we have the radius OM, it is drawn to the point of tendency, therefore tangent CB will be perpendicular to the radius MO, that is to say this angle equals 90 degrees and this angle equals 90 degrees according to rule number 1. Then we have here the peripheral angle ACB that rests on the diameter of the circle, and any peripheral angle that rests on the diameter of a circle must be equal to 90 degrees. So this angle ACB equals to 90 degrees. Actually, in quadrilateral ONCM, we have 1, 2 free right angles. The sum of free right angles is 19 times 3 is 270 degrees, plus the size of the fourth angle, that is actually angle MON. In total, they must be equal to 360 degrees. We subtract the 270 degrees from this equation, we found out that there is an angle MON equals to 90 degrees. This angle equals to 90 degrees, therefore, inside quadrilateral ONCM, we have four right angles. Any quadrilateral that has four right angles must be at least a rectangle, if not a square. So we relate to quadrilateral ONCM as a rectangle. And we also know that the opposite sides of a rectangle are equal to each other. So rectangle ONCM, ON must be equal to CM. ON must be equal to CM. But we already found out that ON equals to 4. ON equals to 4, and from this equation 4 equals to ON equals to CM, we will derive that CM is also equals to 4 units. If CM equals to 4 units, for, according to the same rule that the opposite sides of a rectangle are equal to each other, we will get that ON equals to NC. ON equals to NC. ON equals to NC. But we already found out that OM equals to 4 units, it is the radius of the small circle. So from this equation 4 equals to OM equals to NC, we derive that NC is also equals to 4 units. Okay? So we actually found out that the quadrilateral ONCM is not a rectangle but a square. Then we defined AC as A, we defined CB as B, and we defined AB as C. What is the length of AN? AN equals to AC minus NC. So AC is A and NC is 4. So in conclusion, AN equals to A minus 4. What is the length of lines M and MB? MB from the domain is very easy to see that MB equals to CB minus CN. MB equals to CB minus CN. So MB equals to CB that is B minus CM that is 4. So in conclusion, MB equals to B minus 4. Okay? Then I presented to you rule number 2. According to rule number 2, the lengths of two tangents from a common extra point to a circle are equal. So if you focus on the common extra point, point A, from point A, we have tangent AN and tangent AL. And according to rule number 2, they are equal to each other on their lengths. So here, AN equals to AN according to rule number 2. But here, we have already found out that AN equals to A minus 4. So we can write here that AN equals to A minus 4. And from this equation, AN equals to A minus 4, we derive that AN is also equals to A minus 4. Here, AN is also equals to A minus 4. Then we focus on the common extra point, point B. From the common extra point, point B, we have two tangents to this circle, to the small circle, tangent BM and tangent BN. And according to rule number 2, they are equal to each other. Here, BL equals to BM according to rule number 2. BL equals to BM according to rule number 2. But we have already found out that BM equals to B minus 4. So we can write here that BM equals to B minus 4. And from this equation, BN equals to BM equals to B minus 4, we derive that BL is also equals to B minus 4. Here, BN is also equals to minus 4. So in conclusion, we found out that BN equals to B minus 4 and AN equals to A minus 4. Again, BN equals to B minus 4 and AN equals to A minus 4. And we know that AB is the diameter of the circle. And the diameter of a circle is twice as long as the radius. So if the radius of the circle equals to 13 units, it means that the diameter must be equal to 13 times 2, that is 26 units. So the diameter of the circle, that is AB, it is equal to 26 units. And it is also equal to C according to our definition. And from the drawing, it is very easy to see that AB equals to AL plus LB. Again, AB equals to AL plus LB. AB equals to AL plus LB. AL, so according to equation number 1, found out that 26 equals to AL plus LB. AL equals to A minus 4, and LB equals to B minus 4. So in conclusion, we found out that 26 equals to A minus 4 plus B minus 4. We substitute AL by AL minus 4 and LB by B minus 4. We found out that 26 equals to A minus 4 plus B minus 4. And then, actually, if A minus 4 plus B minus 4 equals to A plus B, minus 4 plus minus 4 is minus 8. So, in conclusion, according to question number 1, A plus B minus 8 equals to 26. We added 8 to this equation, equation number 1, and we found out that A plus B equals to 26 plus 8 is 34. So, A plus B equals to 34 according to question number 1. We squared this equation, equation number 1, and we found out that A plus B squared equals to 34 squared. We opened the brackets on both sides of this equation, equation number 1, and found out that A plus B squared equals to A squared plus B squared plus 2 times AB, and 34 squared equals to 1156. Okay. Then, here we have A squared plus B squared plus 2 times AB equals to 1156 according to equation number 1. Then we focus on the right triangle ABC. ABC is the right triangle because this angle equals to 90 degrees. We implemented the Pythagoras theorem on the right triangle ABC. The square of the hypotenuse equals to the sum of the squares of the perpendiculars, that is to say, AB squared equals to AC squared plus CB squared. Here AB squared equals to AC squared plus CB squared. AB equals to C, so AB squared equals to C squared. And AC equals to A, so AC squared is A squared plus CB squared. CB equals to B, so CB squared is B squared. So in conclusion, we found out that C squared equals to A squared plus B squared. C equals to 26, so we substituted C by 26. So C squared is 26 squared. That is equal to A squared plus B squared. 26 squared is 676. So in conclusion, we found out that A squared plus B squared equals to 676. And then, because of the fact that A squared plus B squared equals to 676, it means that we can substitute A squared plus B squared in equation number 1 by 676. We did it, and we got that according to equation number 1, A squared plus B squared, that is equal to 676, plus 2 times AB equals to 1156. Here we subtracted 676 from this equation, equation number 1, and we found out that the 2 times AB equals to 1156 equals to 480. We divided this equation, so we found out that 2 times AB equals to 480. We divided this equation, equation number 1 by 2, and we found out that AB equals to 480 over 2 is 240. So AB equals to 240. We divided this equation, equation number 1 by 2, and we found out that AB over 2 equals to 120. Okay, then what is the area of the blue shape? The area of the blue shape equals to the area of triangle ABC minus the area of the small circle. Very, very simple. The area of the blue shape equals to the area of triangle ABC minus the area of the small circle. The area of triangle ABC equals to the base of the triangle, that is AC times the height to the base, that is C over 2. CB over 2, and the area of the small circle equals to pi r squared when r equals to 4 units. So here AC equals to A, BC equals to B. So AC times BC is A times B, and AC times BC is A times B over 2. Here pi r squared, r equals to 4, so r squared is 4 squared, that is 16, so pi r squared is 16 pi. And we have already found out that AB over 2 equals to 120, so we can substitute AB over 2 by 120. We did it, and we got that the area of the small shape, in conclusion, equals to 120 minus 16 pi square units. So in terms of numbers, the area of the blue shape equals to 69.73 square units. We finished with the first question, then I presented to you the second question, and we solved the second question in 3 different methods. In the first method, here we have a triangle ABC is inscribed by this circle. The area of triangle ABC equals to 9 square units. Side AB equals to 5 units. Side AC equals to 6 units. And we want to find out the area of this circle that draws triangle ABC. So first of all, from point A, we draw perpendicular on BC. We define the touching point between the perpendicular from point A and BC as D. So this angle equals to 90 degrees, and this angle also equals to 90 degrees according to our construction. So hopefully the area of triangle ABC equals to 9 square units. This is given as the question. And the area of triangle ABC equals to the base of the triangle, that is BC, times the height to the base, that is AD over 2. BC equals to 6, AD is the missing 9 segment over 2. So we found out that 9 equals to 6 over 2 is 3. So 9 equals to 3 AD. Then we divided this equation, equation number 1, by 3, and we found out that AD equals to 3 units. if AD equals to 3 units, then we focused on the right triangle ABD. According to the Pythagoras theorem, the square of the hypotenuse equal to the sum of the squares of the perpendiculars. And we found out that if BD equals to 4 units, then we implemented the Pythagoras theorem on the right triangle ADC, and we found out that AC equals to the square of 13 units. Then, from point A, we define the center of, therefore DC equals to 2 units, of course, and here we define the center of this circle as O. We join points A and O together by a straight line, and then we extended line segment AO until it touches the circle at point E. AE passes through the center of the circle, therefore it is the diameter of the circle. We join points A and B together by a straight line. Here A, B, E rests on the diameter, therefore it is equal to 90 degrees. Those two angles are also equal to each other because of the fact that they rest on the same chord, chord AB. So if this angle equals to theta, this angle must be also equal to theta. So this angle equals to 90 degrees, this angle equals to theta, so this angle must be equal to 90 degrees minus theta, therefore, for the same reason, this angle must be also equal to 90 degrees minus theta. Then we prove that those two triangles are similar to each other, while those two angles are equal to each other, they are both equal to 90 degrees minus theta. Those two angles are both equal to 90 degrees, therefore they are equal to each other. Those two angles are both equal to theta, therefore they are equal to each other. So we found out that triangle AB is similar to triangle ADC according to angle similarity rule. And from the fact that those two triangles are similar to each other, we conclude that AB over AD equals to AE over AC. AB is 5, AD is 3. AE is the diameter of the circle, that is 2R, and AC is square root of 13. We multiplied this equation by square root of 13, and found out that 5 times square root of 13 over 3 equals to 2R. We divided this equation by R, and found out that R, the radius of the circle that we are looking for, equals to either 5 times square root of 13 over 6 units, or in terms of numbers, it is a little bit greater than 3 units. Then I presented to you how to find out the area of this circle that draws triangle ABC according to the second method. In the second method, from point A we draw perpendicular on BC, so this is point C, this angle equals 20 degrees, this angle equals 20 degrees according to our construction. According to the first method, BD equals to 4 units, DC equals to 2 units, and AD equals to 3 units. And then we implemented rule number 1 in our drawing. According to rule number 1, if chord AB intersects with chord CD, at point O, then AO times OB equals to CO times OD. Here we have in our drawing chord AE intersects with chord BD at point D, therefore BD times DC equals to AE times equals to AD times DE. BD times DC equals to AD times DE. According to rule number 1, BD is 2, DC is BD is 4, DC is 2, AD is 3, and DE is the missing line segment. So by solving this equation, we found out that DE equals to 8 over 3 units. Then I presented to you rule number 2. According to rule number 2, if chord AB intersects with chord CD at 90 degrees, then 4 times R squared equals to A squared plus B squared plus C squared plus D squared. We can implement rule number 2 in our drawing, because in our drawing, chord AE intersects with chord BC at 90 degrees, therefore we get that 4 times R squared equals to CD squared plus DB squared plus AE squared plus DE squared, 4 times squared equals to BD squared plus DC squared plus AD squared. plus the e squared, only 2 on number 2. We solve this equation and found out that the radius of this circle, that is the only missing variable, it is equal to either 5 over 6 times 4 to 14, so in terms of numbers it is a little bit greater than 3 on this. Then I presented to you a third method to find out the radius of this circle that blocks triangle ABC. We defined angle ABC as theta, and we have a special formula to find out the area of any triangle. The area of this triangle is A times B times sin theta over 2. So according to this formula, the area of our triangle, triangle ABC, will be equal to 5 times 6 times sin theta over 2. 5 times 6 times sin theta over 2. We know that the area of the triangle equals to 9 square units, so 9 equals to 5 times 6 is 30, and 30 over 2 is 15. We solved this equation and found out that sin of theta equals to 3/5, and we have the trigonometric identity that cosine theta equals to the square root of 1 minus sin of square theta. We put the sin of square theta in this equation and found out that cosine theta equals to 4/5. Then we implemented the law of cosines in triangle ABC. According to the law of cosines in any triangle, cosine theta equals to a squared plus b squared minus c squared over 2 times ab. In our triangle, ABC, cosine theta will be equal to 5 squared plus 6 squared minus ac squared over 2 times 5 times 6. Here, cosine theta equals to 5 squared, that is 25, plus 6 squared, that is 36, minus ac squared over 2 times 5 times 6. We solved this equation and found out that AC equals to square root of 13 units. Then I presented to you a new formula to find out the area of to find out the radius of any circle that blocks triangle ABC. The radius of this circle will be equal to the multiplication of the sides of the triangle that is blocked by the circle over 4 times the area of the triangle that is blocked by the circle. In our case, it is AB times AC times BC over 4 times the area of this triangle ABC, that is 9 units. AB is 5, AC is square root of 13, BC is 6, and the area of triangle ABC is 9. So in conclusion, we found out that R equals to 30, 5 times 6 is 30, times square root of 13, times square root of 13 units, over 4 times 9 is 36. So we found out in conclusion that the radius of the circle equals to either 5 over 6 times square root of 13 units, so in terms of numbers, it is equal to 3 units. It is a little bit greater than 3 units. Okay, thank you very much.